students. Myself Shilpa, working in KMS SNH Ringappa College. Today I am going to explain the experiment angle of minimum deviation for a given user. Okay, that one you are studying in the second PU practicals. Okay, let's see aim of the experiment. Okay, so you can see here aim, determination of angle of minimum deviation for a glass prism by plotting a graph between the angle of deviation and angle of incidence. Okay, let's see the principle of the experiment. The angle of deviation is the angle between the incident ray and the emergent ray. You have studied this one in the theory, right? And we can see here at minimum deviation the light ray passes through the prism symmetrically. Therefore, in the principle we will write angle of incidence is always equals to angle of emergence. Okay, now let's see what are the apparatus required for this experiment. Okay, so we need of this whiteboard, white sheet and pins. Here is the prism. Okay, we have to find angle of minimum deviation for a given prism. We require protractor, as usual scale, okay, and pencil as well as pen. Okay, yes, let's start the experiment. Now I will show you how to find angle of minimum deviation. Okay, so first we will consider this white sheet. We will fix with respect to pins. Okay, now first always draw horizontal line. Okay, and draw the normal. Okay, yes, at the point of intersection write that one by O. Okay, now first observation. Okay, first observation we are making, that one is for angle of incidence. The angle of incidence we will consider 33 degree. Okay, angle of incidence we are considering 33 degree. Therefore we will mark now 33 degree. You can see here, yes. Okay, now 0 10 20 30, so I am marking for 33 degree. Okay, just a point, then join that point with respect to the incidence, that is intersection, okay, of normal with the incident ray. This is our incident ray, so mark the direction by putting the arrow. Okay, now angle we have measured, always angle of incidence we will measure between incident ray and the normal. So I will write angle I, that one is equals to 33 degree. Okay, we will write that one with respect to 33 degree. Now I will place the prism. You can see here the prism is having three surfaces, two refracting surfaces and one we are having rough surface, that one we will consider as a base. Okay, but now I will place this prism, okay, such that the base is along the horizontal line. Base is along the horizontal line, and I will mark the points here. Okay, yes, and now I am going to put two pins. I will consider this as a my first pin. I am placing it on the incident ray. Similarly, I will consider another pin, that is my second pin. I will place it on the incident ray. Okay, and make sure both should be at same height. Okay, so these two points on the line which gives the incident ray. Now I will consider the third pin. Okay, and I will put such that the two pins will look like a one. Okay, so whenever we perform optical experiments, remember we have to close one eye. Okay, with the help of one eye only we have to place the pin. This is my third pin. Okay, so
looking into the looking into the two pins. Yeah, now for me those two are looking like a single pin, so I put the third pin. You can see here. Yeah, okay, two are looking like a one. Can you see inside the prism? Yeah, okay. Now I will consider the fourth pin. Okay, I will place such that all the three pins should look like a one. Okay, all the three should look like a one, such that I am placing my fourth pin. Okay, now you can see clearly all the four pins are along a straight line. Okay, yes, you can see the upweave also. Here two pins along the incident ray, correct? Along the incident ray, and these two pins we have placed for the emergent ray. Okay, now I will take out the prism. I will take out my prism. Okay, and here we are having two points, correct? Just mark them. Okay, just mark them. Now before joining them, this is our incident ray, right? Now we have to extend it. If there is no prism at that time, the light ray will follow the same path, correct? Now these two points we are having, right? Okay, join them and extend in the backward direction. This gives us emergent ray. This two pins when we join, we will get the emergent ray. And all of we know the angle between incident ray, angle between incident ray and the emergent ray, we will get the deviation, correct? We will get angle of deviation. So now we will measure that deviation. Okay, now we will measure that deviation. For that we have to place again protractor. Yes, now we can see here 10 20 30 40 41 and 42, correct? Here you can see this line, it crosses at 42. So I will write here angle of deviation as a 42 degree. Understood? Now in the tabular column we can see here, in the tabular column I had written already angle of incidence. We made how much? We took that one as a 33 degree, correct? So we have to write first angle of incidence 33 degree. Correspondingly I got angle of deviation 42 degree, correct? So I entered that one as a angle of deviation as a 42 degree. Okay, next second trial we will make angle of incidence 36 degree. Correspondingly we will note down our deviation. I already did that one. I will show you. See, for the second observation, for the second observation angle of incidence is 36 degree, and corresponding deviation I got as a 40. Similarly third trial incidence I took as a 39 degree. Correspondingly I got angle of deviation as a 39 degree. For the fourth observation, consider angle of incidence as a 42 degree. Corresponding angle of deviation we got as a 41 degree. Similarly fifth trial I got angle of incidence as a 45 degree. Corresponding angle of deviation as a 43 degree. Then for 48 degree of angle of incidence, for the sixth observation you can see here angle of deviation I got as a 46 degree. So in the tabular column angle of incidence we will increase in terms of 33 degree, starting from 33 36, 39, 42, 45, 48. Correspondingly, we have to enter the angle of deviation. Okay, the procedure is same, right? Once again, I will, okay, first draw the horizontal line, put the normal, okay, with respect to normal, using the protractor, measure the angle of incidence, okay, from that point, draw the line that gives incident ray, okay, then we have to place the prism, okay, we have to place the prism, okay, looking into two pins, first pin and second pin, where we will put them along the incident ray, okay, take the third pin, put that one such that these two will look like a single pin, take the fourth pin, put that one such that all the three pins, all the three pins should look like a single pin, okay, then you have to take out the prism, you have to take out the prism, okay, extend the incident ray, 2 points we will get from the pin, extend that one in the backward direction, we will get angle of deviation, because angle of deviation is between incident ray and the emergent ray, okay, same thing you have to follow it for increase angle of incidence by 33 degree and note down correspondingly deviation, okay. Now after entering all the values, okay, we will plot the graph. We can see here angle of incidence, okay, minimum value is 33, maximum is 48, so it will lie between 0 to 50 degree, correct? Similarly, you can see angle of deviation, minimum value we are having is here 39, okay, and maximum we will go up to 46, correct? So here also the readings will lie between 0 to 50 degree. So when we plot the graph, okay, always along x-axis we will make angle of incidence, that is I. Along y-axis we will represent that one by angle of deviation d, and equally we will divide each unit as a 5 degree, 10, 15 up to 50 degree. Similarly along x-axis also one unit is equals to 5 degree. So I had written the scale along x-axis one unit equals 5 degree, along y-axis one unit equals 5 degree. After put the points, okay, after joining we will get the curve, and we can see here at 39 degree, okay, at 39 degree we will get angle of minimum deviation, okay, so we will draw the line, we will join that one, okay, that gives us angle of minimum deviation, okay, yes, that one we will write as a result also, okay. In the result you can see, after plotting the graph, you can see here this point gives us angle of minimum deviation for a given prism. Here it is 35, 36, 37, 38, 39. So I have written that one as the angle of minimum deviation. We will represent that one by del subscript m, that one is equals to 39 degree. Okay, and also from readings you can see here, as angle of incidence is increasing, angle of incidence is increasing, okay, deviation is decreasing, correct? Deviation is decreasing, okay, but once it reaches its minimum value, once it reaches its minimum value, that is at 39 degree, after that when you increase the angle of incidence, you can see here the angle of deviation also goes on increases. The angle of deviation also goes on increases. So from graph also we can see, as well as from our readings, between angle of incidence and angle of deviation you can see 39 degree, okay, is the minimum deviation, okay, that's why we have written result as a angle of deviation, okay, yes students.